Welcome to Founders Metropolitan Community Church.
We are so glad that you are here to worship with us today.
Along with our Sunday worship,
Founders MCC offers a rich assortment of personal and spiritual enrichment classes,
a variety of activities,
and a number of support groups to help us grow along the way.
Don't forget to visit the information and welcome table in the courtyard today,
or pick up one of the Connections flyers to find out more.
Please don't miss out on the information and announcements in your bulletin,
which will make your connection with Founders more meaningful.
Check out our website, MCCLA.org.
And find us also on Facebook.
And join us in making Founders MCC
your one-stop spiritual portal.
This is your first Sunday at Founders.
You are our guest.
We would like to extend an especially warm welcome.
After today's worship service, please join us for refreshments in the courtyard.
Visit the Welcome and Information Center.
And meet some new friends.
We'd love to answer your question,
give you a tour of the building,
or serve you a cup of coffee.
Or a cup of tea.
In just a few moments, the ushers will pass out our welcome tablet.
We want everyone to sign in today and let us know how we can best serve you.
If you're joining us online, we want to hear from you as well. Look for the check-in information on the homepage of our website.
And let us know that you're joining us.
Founders MCC is a place of diversity and welcome.
A place of healing and acceptance.
A place of deep spirituality and transformation.
A place of joy and love.
Welcome to Founders Metropolitan
Community Church, Los Angeles.
Thank you.
This morning we once again light our Advent wreath. Throughout this season of Advent, we have lit candles to remind us of hope and peace, of joy and of love. And we have lit three candles, the first for hope, the second for peace, and the third for joy. Today we light the fourth candle, the candle of love. With this flame, we signify the love of God that surrounds and fills us at all times, but that we recognize in a special way in this Christmas story. There is no greater power than love. It is stronger than rulers and empires, stronger than grief or despair, stronger than even death itself. We love because God loves us. So as we light these candles, join me in a moment of prayer. Loving God, we open ourselves to you this Christmas season. As these candles are lit, light our lives with your imagination. Show us the creative power of hope. Teach us the peace that comes from justice. Fill us with the kind of joy that cannot be contained but must be shared. Magnify your love within us. Prepare our hearts to be transformed by you, that we may live in the light of Christ. Amen. God bless you this morning. Please be seated. It is, as always, a joy to welcome you to Founders Metropolitan Community Church on this beautiful Sunday morning. Today is a special Sunday for us, for it is the Sunday that we do worship a little differently. It's our Lessons and Carol service. It's an opportunity for us to hear the Christmas story afresh and anew, but through the sacred text of our scriptures, and to listen and to share in the wonderful Christmas music through carols and through song. So we are delighted that you have chosen to be with us today. We're also delighted to welcome you if indeed this is your first Sunday at Founders Metropolitan Community Church. We're glad that you're here. We know that you have a choice in worshiping communities, but we are so happy that you have decided to join us today. I wonder if you would indulge my spirit if indeed you are with us for the very first Sunday today. I wonder if you would just raise your hand up for a moment so that we can see you, so that we can welcome you to worship this morning. Ushers will get to you, but please do accept this pamphlet and brochures about our church and about how we are connected one with the other. And if you're looking for a spiritual home, we sincerely wish and hope that you have found it with us this morning. We also want to welcome all of our folks who are worshiping with us online this morning. We know that on a Sunday, about 500 folks from around the world join us in worship throughout the world, and we want to welcome you today. In just a few moments, our ushers will be passing out our welcome tablets, and so we invite every single person in our church to sign in for us today. Please let us know that you've been present, whether this is your first Sunday or you've been with us for many, many Sundays. It's important for us to know that you've been present. And for those of you who are worshiping online, this is an opportunity also for you to connect with us. So please hit that little box that says check in for us on our front page of our website, and we will acknowledge that welcome in the next day or so. But we are so glad that each and every one of us is here. As you came in, the ushers would have given you orders of worship, and on the front page and on the inside flap, you will see the order of today's service, and you'll also see all of the announcements for today and for the upcoming weeks. We are a busy congregation, and so we invite you to take a moment to review the announcements and then to mark in your own calendars the events and ministries that you would like to be a part of. Want to just remind you of Christmas services. We have two Christmas services on Christmas Eve. The first will be at 8:30 and the second service will be at 11 o'clock, which will run through the midnight hour. And then on Christmas Day, we have our services at 11 o'clock in the morning. And then, of course, we'll be back the following Sunday for our usual schedule of services, 9 and 11 in English and 1:30 service in Spanish. So please do join us over the Christmas holidays. For those of you who are regulars at Metropolitan Community Church here at Founders, you will have hopefully spotted that our new organ has arrived and is in place. It's not in its permanent configuration, but will be very quickly in the new year. But we want to encourage you to come back on Christmas Eve, because the organ will be played on Christmas Eve services. So please do come back and worship with us on Christmas Eve. As I say, we are a busy congregation, but we are glad that you are here this morning. So can we turn now to one another and offer a sign of peace, a sign of welcome, as we affirm that we're in the right place this morning. God bless you.
Good morning. Our first reading this morning is from the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verses 26 through 28, and chapter 5, verses 1 and 2, taken from the New International Version. Then God said, "Let us make humankind in our image, in our likeness, so that they may rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky, over the livestock and all the animals, and over all the wild animals, and over all the creatures that move along the ground." So God created humankind, and the image of God, in the image of God, God created them. God blessed them and said to them, "Be fruitful and increase in number. Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky, and over every living creature that moves on the ground." This is the written account of Adam and Eve's family line. When God created humankind, God made them in the likeness of God. God created them and blessed them and named them human when they were created. Hear what the Spirit says today. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Verses 8 through 17. Then God said to Noah and to his sons with him,
I now establish my covenant with you and with your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, the birds, the livestock, and all the wild animals, all those that came out of the ark with you, every living creature on earth. I establish my covenant with you. Never again will all life be destroyed by the waters of a flood. Never again will there be a flood to destroy the earth. And God said, this is the sign of the covenant I am making between me and you and every living creature with you, a covenant for all generations to come. I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it will be the sign of the covenant between me and the earth. Whenever I bring clouds over the earth and the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will remember my covenant between me and you and all living creatures of every kind. Never again will the waters become a flood to destroy all life. Whenever the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and all living creatures of every kind on the earth. So God said to Noah, this is the sign of the covenant I have established between me and all life on the earth. Hear what the Spirit says today.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
If you hear this message, wherever you stand, calling every woman, calling every man, with a generation can afford to wait. The future started yesterday, we're already late. We've been looking for a song to sing, search for a melody, search for someone to lead. We've been looking for the world to change. If you feel the same, go on and say, if you're out there, sing along with me. If you're out there, I'm dying to believe that you're out there. Stand up and say it loud if you're out there. Tomorrow's starting now. Now, now.
No more broken promises. No more call to war.
Unless it's love and peace that we're really fighting for.
We can destroy hunger. We can't conquer hate. Put down the arms and raise your voice. Join in hands today. Oh, I was looking for a song to sing. I searched for a leader, but the leader was me. Oh, we've been looking for the world to change. We can be heroes. Just go on and say if you're out.
Along with me if you're out there.
I'm dying to believe
that you're out there. Stand up and say it loud if you're out there.
Tomorrow's starting now. Now, now. Oh, now.
If you're out there, oh,
oh, if you're out there and you're ready now, say it loud, scream it out if you're out there.
Sing along with me if you're out there.
I'm dying to believe
that you're out there. And say it loud if you're out there.
Tomorrow starting now.
message wherever you stand. Calling every woman, calling every man. We're the generation can't afford to wait. The future started yesterday, and we're already late.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2, 6, and 7 from the New International Version. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting One, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. Hear what the Spirit says today. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Reading from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 1, verses 26 through 35 and verse 38. This is from the New International Version. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you. The power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her. Hear what the Spirit says today.
Good morning. I'd like to invite TL to come join me, please. Sense of wonder. You get your fill to eat, but always keep that hunger. May you never take one single breath for granted. And God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. And promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. Hope you still feel small when you, uh-oh. Small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Living life means taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some hell-bent heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out, reconsider. And give the heavens above more than just a passing glance. Then when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, time rolling us along. Tell me who wants to look back on their years and wonder where those years have gone. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope another one opens. But promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance.
That was touching. I hope you dance. A reading from the book of Isaiah, verses 1 through 4 and verses 6 through 9, taken from the New International Version. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From its roots, a branch will bear fruit. The spirit of the sovereign God will rest on him, the spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the spirit of counsel and of might, the spirit of knowledge and awe of God. And he will delight in the awe of God. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes, or decide by what he hears with his ears. But the righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with the rod of his mouth. With the breath of his lips he will slay the wicked. The wolf will live with the lamb. The leopard will lie down with the goat. The calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a child, a little child, will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear. Their young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play to get near the cobra's den. The young child will put its hand into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain. For the earth will be filled with the knowledge of God as the waters cover the sea. Hear what the Spirit says today. Thanks be to God. Amen.
reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 2, verse 1, and verses 3 through 7, taken from the Message. About that time, Caesar Augustus ordered a census to be taken throughout the empire. This was the first census when Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everyone had to travel to their own ancestral hometown to be accounted for. So Joseph went from the Galilean town of Nazareth up to Bethlehem in Judah, David's town, for the census. As a descendant of David, he had to go there. He went with Mary, his fiancée, who was pregnant. Hear what the Spirit says today.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
Russians celebrate Christmas too. I was just minding my own business in the Sochi airport bathroom. Well, not exactly. I had scared some uptight girls out. Seems they thought there was a man in here for some reason. And I was fixing my face, covering the bruises. Of all people who should come on in, Gabby, the big protest cheerleader, and Martina, the famous lesbian surrogate mother. I figured the proud papas of the story, Joseph and his husband Sasha, were probably waiting outside.
Oh my goodness, how many people do you think are waiting outside, Joseph?
About 50 of our folks talking to the arriving Olympic tourists and a couple of hundred screaming homophobes.
I'd heard they were all planning to leave Russia before the proposals to ban gays and lesbians from parenting came up again. I could have just walked out, but I didn't. Gabby didn't even recognize me at first. I'm Tatiana, the trans sex worker who got beat up last week. Remember the case your group decided not to take on?
Oh, hello. I'm glad you came out today anyway.
Hey, I just wanted to see if I can spot thugs who tried to kill me.
I think something just happened.
Well, Martina's water had broken. I knew. Before I was a trans hooker, I was a nurse in a gynecologist's office. So anyway, we had to shut the bathroom down, so I set off the stink bomb I had originally brought along as a gift for those homophobes.
Ew!
I let Joseph and Sasha in.
Ew! It smells like a stable in here.
And thought that would be the end of it for me, but I let them get in my head.
Tatiana, it can't be an accident that you're here right now.
I was just fixing my makeup.
It's a huge moment, Tatiana, but I realize we were pretty nasty to you.
Maybe this little baby being born could put the things right between us.
Please, help me, Tatiana.
So, I delivered their baby.
She pushed me into the diaper changing stall, and I had him right there.
Prettiest little boy you'd ever want to see. Gabby made quite a speech to get the demonstrators help, so the little family could slide by the authorities who were after them.
Okay, everybody. I've got good news and bad news. The good news is that a living, breathing symbol of freedom has fallen right into our laps. The bad news is that we're practically alone in Russia, standing up to hysterical homophobia against impossible odds. Now, you wouldn't be out here if you didn't believe in something greater than 50 people with a bunch of flyers. step out of your agenda and help us bring a little joy to the world.
And then an amazing thing happened. We sneaked out of the bathroom.
I've got Martina and the baby. Joseph,
I'm right behind you, honey.
The homophobes have spotted us.
But then the other queer folk pulled the Olympic tourists together to form a shield around them.
These wonderful people are carrying us right out of the airport.
The press ate it up.
Tatiana, well, we couldn't be more blown away by what you've done for us today.
We can't thank you enough.
Guess I got caught up in the moment.
You sure showed them, Tatiana.
Good luck, honey, and be careful. I don't think President Putin is going to be happy about this.
Gracias a ustedes. A reading according to the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 2, verses 8 through 16, taken from the English Standard Version. And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel appeared to them, and the glory of God shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom God is pleased." When the angels went away from them unto heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which God has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. Hear what the Spirit says today.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
Good morning, I'm Rose Jaeger, I'm the board member on duty. And this is a season of blessings, isn't it?
Yes.
A time to bless one another with presence, to be blessed by presence, to be blessed with our presence here today. Did you get that? All right, so I'm nervous. Okay, so we've been blessed with an organ, with presents for Tijuana and the Sunset Clinic. Absolutely, that deserves applause. Blessed with so much, a beautiful choir that sings so well.
Yes.
And is beautiful, but sounds lovely too. A staff here at the church that ministers to us each and every day, so thank you so much for that. I also would like to share at this time that Phoebe and I are also blessed. I'm 12 weeks pregnant as of Friday. And the next person who asked me if I know the dad, I'm gonna tell them it's Immaculate Conception, but you know. I've just been toying with that one. Anyways, the thing about this process for us has been that one of our biggest fears is that our families are not here, like our physical families. My family's in Indiana, Phoebe's is, well, all over, but not here. What we rely and take great pride in, and I'm quite blessed by, is this congregation in this place. We're gonna need that support, and so we're already thankful for you. If you, like us, feel as blessed as we are about having this place, I would ask that you give of your time and your talent, and as well today I'm here to ask you for your treasure as well. Today, we're also asking for the board would love to give the staff a bonus, so we're here also to ask you for bonuses for the staff today. And if you forgot, we announced it last week. I just would kindly remind you that you can also, you know, give us credit card information. We'll take that and process that and can do that as well. So thank you all for your gifts and your offerings. Please pray with me. I also need to remind you that second offering is going to be in a plate up here in the front, and that Helping Hands will not be this Sunday, but will be next Sunday in place of this offering today. So please pray with me. Light of the world, thank you so much for all that you do for us each and every day, and the blessings that you have granted each and every one of us. Help us here. The board and your church use these gifts that have been so generously given to us to do your will in the world today. Amen. Amen.
To that song. Always happens when you are driven by PowerPoint. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew chapter 2 verses 1 through 12, taken from the contemporary English version. When Jesus was born in the village of Bethlehem in Judea, Herod was king. During this time, some wise ones from the east came to Jerusalem and said, "Where is the child born, the King of the Jews? We saw the star in the east and have come to worship." When King Herod heard about this, he was worried, and so was everyone else in Jerusalem. Herod brought together the chief priests and the teachers of the law of Moses and asked them, "Where will the Messiah be born?" They told him, "He will be born in Bethlehem, just as the prophet wrote, 'Bethlehem in the land of Judea. You are very important among the towns of Judea. From your town will come a leader who will be like a shepherd of my people Israel.'" Herod secretly called in the Magi and asked them when they had first seen the star. He told them, "Go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, let me know, for I want to go and worship him too." The Magi listened to what the king said and then left. And the star they had seen in the east went on ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. They were thrilled and excited to see the star. When they went into the house and saw the child with Mary, his mother, they knelt down and worshipped him. They took out their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and gave them to him. Later, they were warned in a dream not to return to Herod, and they went back home by another road. Hear what the Spirit says today. Thanks be to God.
Amen. Thank you.
O come, Emmanuel. We are still waiting for you. We are waiting for the Prince of Peace. We are waiting for the wisdom from on high. We are waiting for the ruler of all nations. O come and set the captives free. For those who are captive to violence, the people of Syria, of South Sudan, of the Ukraine, the victims of domestic violence and abuse, those who see violence as a solution to their problems, or those of this world.
Free those who are captives to poverty, those unable to find work, and those whose work cannot supply their need. The long-term unemployment in the United States who may be affected by the expiration of their unemployment benefits. Those who work in sweatshops and mines. The children of New Zealand, over one quarter of whom live in poverty, and children throughout the world who live in poverty. Free those who are captive to fear and hatred. Those nations divided by histories of rivalry and conflict, Iran and Israel, India and Pakistan, Roma and Europa, and those who fear others based on race or ethnicity.
Free those who are captive to sorrow, those who grieve the loss of a loved one, those who are alone, those who suffer from depression, those for whom this time of celebration is a time of sadness. May you, Lord, turn all our sorrow into joy. May our souls rejoice at your appearing. May we magnify you as we sing, and may all the world be glad at the light of your presence. Come, Lord Jesus, be our light in the darkness, and may we come before your presence with a song, for you are our light and our salvation. And to you we lift our voices in prayer and thanksgiving now and always. Amen.
Amen. As we prepare for the one who is coming into our lives, as we prepare for the one who is coming to where we live, but we know how often we have wandered away, divorcing ourselves from God. So in a moment of silence, let us confess to the one who comes to forgive us and give us new life. Please join with me in the words of the open confession, which will appear on our screen in just a moment or so. And if not, we'll just give an assurance of pardon. For our confession in silence is enough. New life, forgiveness, hope, and peace. These are the gifts of the holy season bestowed upon us by our gracious God. We will take our gifts and share them with everyone we meet as we commit to Christ's way of peace and of hope.
Through your love of the world, the Word became flesh and lived among us. As the angels caroled glory to you in the highest heavens and peace to all people on earth, so we join with them and with all people to praise your name. Holy Lord, God of endless love, heaven and earth are surely full of your glory. Yes. The angels sang of it. The shepherds encountered it. We have been blessed with it. Yes. Blessed is he who is born this night. Glory to God and on earth, peace to all people. As you, God, shared your love and yourself with us in the person of Jesus, so he shared himself with us in loving us and giving himself for us.
On that never-to-be-forgotten night, as he sat at the table, he took bread, he blessed it, giving thanks. He broke it, In sharing it with his friends, he said, "Take and eat, for this is my body, which is broken for you. And every time you come together, simply remember me." After they had eaten, he took the cup, giving thanks and blessing. He said, "Remember me as you drink from this, for it is my life poured out for you, the beginning of a new relationship with God." Send the power of your Holy Spirit upon us, that we may experience the presence of the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ. Breathe your Spirit in us, that we may be one body with Christ, faithfully following and serving and awaiting the expectation, the coming of his dominion. Amen.
Amen. Friends, here at Founders Metropolitan Community Church, as with metropolitan community churches all over the world, we serve and celebrate what is called an open communion. By this we mean that you do not need to be a member of this church or indeed of any other Christian organization in order to come and receive of communion this morning. If you choose to come forward, you'll receive a wafer which has been dipped in non-alcoholic grape juice, placed upon your tongue, or you may take and dip and receive yourself, and we will offer you a personal prayer of blessing. We invite you to come alone, with loved ones, with husbands, wives, boyfriends, girlfriends, significant other or significant others, or folks that you have just met this day. But know that this table does not belong to us. It belongs to the one who set it for us, Jesus the Christ. So maybe you come from a tradition where you've been told you're not welcome unless you have fit some kind of criteria. That does not exist here. The only criteria we ask is that you come with an open heart, ready to receive whatever that gift might be for you as you come to this table. We do have only one rule, and that is that you follow the directions of the ushers who will get us to the table and back in safety this morning. So as we finish preparing this table, may I invite the ushers, the acolytes, the servers to come so that we might be ready to serve.
lesson. I think you may be seated. A reading according to the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 1, verses 1 through 14, taken from the Message. The Word was first. The Word present to God. God present to the Word. The Word was God, in readiness from God from day one. Everything was created through God. Nothing, not one thing, came into being without God. What came into existence was life. And the light was and the life was light to live by. The life light blazed out of the darkness. The darkness couldn't put it out. There once was a man, his name John, sent by God to point out the way to the life light. He came to show everyone where to look, who to believe in. John was not the light. He was there to show the way to the light. The life light was the real thing. Every person entering life, Christ brings the light. Christ brings into light. He was in the world. The world was there through him, and yet the world didn't even notice. He came to his own people, but they didn't want him. But whoever did, who believed he was who he claimed and would do what he said, he made to be their true selves, their child of God selves. These are the God begotten. Not blood begotten, not flex begotten, not sex begotten. The Word became flesh and blood and moved into the neighborhood. We saw the glory with our own eyes, the one of kind glory. Like God, like Son, generous inside and out, true from start to finish. Hear what the Spirit says today. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
When I think about the Lord, how you save me, how you raise me, how you fill me with the Holy Ghost, and how you heal me to the uttermost. When I think about the Lord, how you pick me up and turn me around.
Now unto God's glorious mercy, God's peace, God's joy, and God's hope we are given unto. And may the blessing of God, known to us as Creator, Savior, and Holy Spirit, be with us and remain with us now and evermore. Amen.
Amen.
Before we go in peace, would you please just show your appreciation to just so many people who not only participated in today's worship, but also have been very, very busy putting up all of our Christmas decorations and singing and just doing so many wonderful things for the church. Please do join us for refreshments after worship, but please remember Christmas Eve, 8:30 in the evening and 11 o'clock in the evening, and Christmas morning at 11 o'clock in the morning. Please do join us as you are able to do so. May I be the very first to wish you in my country a happy Christmas. And we still say Happy New Year, although just for giggles, and a Merry New Year. Amen. Today. By participating with us online, you are an extension of this church's membership ministry, our extended fellowship. Whether you're tuning in from Los Angeles, London, Tokyo, or Zimbabwe, wherever you are in the world, we are so excited to embrace you, to hear from you, and to pray for you. all of the people you've just seen in this broadcast, not just the ministers and the choir, but every person sitting on those pews, we are here for you. So please, why don't you connect with us? Interact with us. We have four ways you can do that: telephone, email, Facebook, and Twitter. And all of those links are located at the bottom of every webpage of our website at mccla.org. With your help, we can not just continue, but expand and reach a greater number of people with God's love through this ministry. Be a video angel amongst us by supporting this ministry through our donate link, located just under the support menu in the upper right corner of any page of our website. Your participation is very important. And I want to invite you to write to me and let me know how I can be in prayer and praise with you. Even though you are not here in our worship center, you are still a part of MCCLA. Email me directly at revneal@mccla.org. May God bless your life. And I look forward to welcoming you back many, many times to MCCLA and our weekly live broadcast. You are